Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss von Neumann architecture. So initially, there were two types of computers, that is fixed program computers and stored program computers. Fixed program computers are the computer systems which were designed to perform various specific tasks, and we cannot alter their functionality or we cannot add in the programs in them later on once they have been designed. For example, we can take calculators. That is the task which calculator perform is very specific. So it comes under the category of fixed program computers. The next one is stored program computers, which can perform the multiple tasks, and we can give instruction to the computer and it can execute our instructions and give us the output. So this is called stored program computers. The computers, computer systems which we are using nowadays are the modern computer systems, and they are introduced by John von Neumann. Let's see the von Neumann architecture here. So the main part of this von Neumann architecture or the von Neumann model are memory, control unit, arithmetic logic unit, input and output. So let's see them one by one. First one is memory, which stores the data on which we have to perform or execute our task. It also stores the intermediate data, that is, which is not the final result, but we need it further to calculate the results. So it stores those values also. Memories in the computer system are of different types. So we will learn them when we'll come to the memory organization chapter. Next one is the control unit. So if we say that the CPU, central processing unit, is the brain of the computer, then the thing which is handling the brain of the computer is the control unit only. As the control unit coordinates between the memory and arithmetic and logic unit, whatever the data needed by the arithmetic and logical unit, control unit takes it from the memory and provide it to the ALU. When the arithmetic and logic unit is done with its task or the calculation, it provides data to the control unit to store it into the memory. So control unit works on the control signals between the memory and the arithmetic and logic unit. The next one is the arithmetic and logic unit only. As the name suggests, that it is designed to perform all the arithmetic operations, that is binary, subtraction, addition, multiplication, and division. So we provide data to the ALU, it performs the task and provide us the result. Next one is input and output. So as we know that the computer systems understand the very specific language, that is the binary language. So we have some peripheral devices attached with the computer system to give us the input or the instruction to it, like mouse and keyboard, etc. So those comes under the input devices, and output devices are those, once we have provided the input, our calculation and the task is performed, and we get the output from the output devices. You can find out the details, whatever we have discussed about the basic components of the von Neumann architecture here, and you can also get these notes on the website www.nargeshgupta.com. There we have provided all the notes topic wise, and also a question paper of the competitive exams and the university exams. So please visit the website once if you need all these materials. Next, there comes a concept, that is von Neumann bottleneck. So what are the shortcomings of the von Neumann architecture that we are going to discuss here? As we know that the von Neumann architecture can handle one instruction at a time. So whatever the task we are performing will get a lot of time to execute, because they will be getting executed in the sequential order and one by one, one instruction at a time. So it increases the execution time of our programs. Next, as the storage in the CPU is very small, so the we need to transfer a lot of data from the CPU's memory, that is from the registers, cache and main memory, to the secondary memory, to and fro, and this also increases the execution time. And the last one is that is it does not supports procedure calls. Like, we cannot implement the functions and procedures in our programs, and we cannot link two different programs together in the von Neumann architecture. So these were the shortcomings, or you can say the drawbacks of the von Neumann architecture, which is known as the von Neumann bottleneck. Thank you.